Enterprise Center. My name is Jacob Reed. I teach choir at Worthing Way Middle School, and I am also the producer of the musical, and this is our theater director, Chris Leyva.
At this time, to prepare for your trip to Neverland, I want to make sure that all your devices, smart or dumb, are all silenced. That way we don't get any fairy dust on them or anything. We just want to make sure they're safe, because I don't think it's covered by your phone manufacturer's warranty. Also, we want to avoid flash photography. Not only is it not safe for the actors because it blinds them, but it also scares fairies, so we want to make sure that we think about the fairy book as well.
Speaking of photos, one of our actors' father, Jason Dale, has been taking great photos of dress rehearsal, full costume, and is also taking video. So I would invite you to maybe not even take any photos or video, because he's going to make all of those available for free to families. Can you give a round of applause to Jason? After the show, the actors are going to meet you in the lobby, so if you could help us by making your way to the lobby to meet your actor, and they will greet you out there before they have to come back and get ready for the next show. So it'll be a brief meeting, but they'll meet you out in the lobby.
Well, speaking of the lobby.
Well, when you get in the lobby, there during the intermission, we do have concessions out there, and all proceeds for concessions go back to the Worthing Way Arts Program to help fund whatever we do here.
Brief warning for those of you in the front row, our actors will be using this aisle quite a bit during the show. They've practiced with people sitting in the seats. They know that there'll be legs there, but we want to let you know you do not want to come out in front of your seats during the show, or there may be some actors in your way. And last, we invite you to send us an email if your actor has made a transformation. Sometimes we see that transformation as teachers, but sometimes it's all going on inside, and that transformation doesn't show up until after they've left our program or after they've left Worthing. That's why we do this. We love making art, we love sharing that passion with our students, but the real reason we do this is because of what it can do for our students, what a great transformation it can make for them, and it keeps us going to hear stories about that, especially the ones we don't get to see. So we invite you to send us a short or a long email if you've seen that in your student. And with that, enjoy the show.
One, two, three. Wendy, John. Mother.
Oh, Mother. You look lovely.
Why, thank you. What are you doing in my old hat?
We're playing a bee. And Father.
Mother, they never let me play. Father, they never let me dance.
Well,
we'll
soon fix that.
Mother! Mother!
What's the matter, George, dear?
Matter? It's time. It will not tie. On the bedpost, oh yes. Or on my neck? Oh dear, no.
I won't take a bath, Matt! I won't take a bath!
Go and be bathed at once, sir! Oh, Mother, look here. A hair all over my trousers. Clumsy, clumsy.
I'll brush you off, Father, dear.
Thank you. You know, Mother, sometimes I think it's a mistake having a dog for a nurse.
George, we must keep now. I'll tell you why. When I came into this room tonight, I saw a face at the window.
The window to close up?
It was the face of a little boy. He was trying to get in.
Impossible.
But wait, the boy was not quite alone. He was accompanied by a ball of light that darted about the room, like a living thing.
That is very unusual.
George, what can all this mean?
Ah! Clumsy, clumsy. Just look at my trousers, covered in dog hair again. I refuse to allow this dog in my nursery for 1 hour longer.
No, Father, you can't take it!
Am I a master in this house, or is she? Come on, Nana. Come, Nana. Good, Nana. Dear Nana. Nice, Nana. You're pretty, Nana. Gotcha!
No, Father! No, you can't take her! Please don't take her! She's awfully unhappy.
That's not her unhappy part. That's her bark when she smells danger.
Can't anything, Mama's Mother, after the nightlights are lit? Nothing precious. They are the eyes Mother leaves behind to guard her children. Now sing your goodnight song and into your beds.
Thank you.
you. There you are. Do you know where they put it? Ah. Shadow, I found you. Stick you on with soap.
Peter, Where do you live?
Neverland.
What does it look like?
It's an island with hardly any space between one adventure and the next.
Neverland. It would be lovely. Who else lives there, Peter?
The Lost Boys.
Who are they?
They are children who fall out of their frames when the nurse is looking the other way. If they aren't claimed in 7 days, they're sent far away to Neverland. I'm Captain.
What fun it must be.
Yes, but we're rather lonely, and none of us knows any stories.
How perfectly awful.
Wendy, your mother was telling you such a lovely story about the prince, and he couldn't find the lady who wore the glass slipper.
Oh, Peter, that's Cinderella. You found her, and they lived happily ever after.
I'm glad.
Where are you going?
To tell the Lost Boys.
Don't go, Peter. I know lots of stories.
Do you?
Oh, Peter, the stories I could tell the boys?
Come with me, Wendy. We'll fly.
Fly. You can fly.
Come with me, and we should all respect you.
Would you teach Michael and John to fly, too?
If you like.
Michael! John! There's a boy here, and he's gonna teach us how to fly!
There is?
Then I chug it up at once!
Roar! Roar! Roar!
afraid of pirates and brave girls when Peter's not around to protect us.
What's taking him so long?
Maybe he's waiting to hear the end of Cinderella.
Cinderella?
Not now, see? He's only one, and I want to mischief all of them. They must live around here somewhere. Scatter and look for them. But most of all, I want their captain, Peter Pan. T'was he who cut off the arm. Oh, I've waited long to shake hands with him. With this.
Yet, I've often heard your was worth a score of hands, pulling the hair of their holy uses.
I see. If I were a mother, I would pray that my children be born with this, instead of that. But Pan flung me hand to a crocodile that happens to be passing by.
I've often noticed your strange dread of crocodiles.
Well, not of crocodiles, but that one crocodile. He liked me hand so much that he has followed me ever since, from land to land, sea to sea. He follows the ship, licking his lips for the rest of me.
In a way, it's sort of a compliment.
Well, I want no such compliments. Smee, that crocodile would have got me. Oh, long ere this, he could have crept upon me unawares. But by some lucky chance, he swallowed a clock.
A clock?
And it goes on, tick, tock, tick, within him. And so, before he can reach me, I hear the tick.
Some little clock will announce and then he'll get you.
Aye, that is the fear that haunts me.
Oh, what's the matter, Captain?
Oh, it's me. This seat's hot. Oh, it's very hot. Oh, hot. Hot. How are my tongs? Smee, help me. A chimney. Peter and the boys must be living underground.
Listen.
Call back the bat. They say that Peter Pan's away from home. I must think. Inspire me.
What tempo, Captain?
Tempo. Ah, a tango.
A tango.
Unflip your plan, Captain.
To cook, take quite large and will each layer in between. With icing mixed with poison, this turns a tempting green. We'll place it near the house, just where the boys are sure to come. And be greedy, they won't care.
slow.
The boys around the world are sweet. One, two, show their mistake. For snow is dangerous to eat. So damp and rich a cake.
I can hear him ticking.
Scream, protect me, protect me.
I love to kiss.
Are you asleep, Wendy? Don't you want to get up and play?
What do we do with her?
We can carry her down to the house.
No, no. We mustn't touch her. That wouldn't be sufficiently respectful. I know. We'll build a house around her.
A house!
I have a plan.
To the ship.
What was that?
Ahoy there, you lovers!
It is the captain. He must be close by.
I tied Tiger to the tree, Captain! Set her free! But, Captain! Cut her bonds or I'll plant me hook in you!
Better do as the captain orders.
Aye, aye!
Ahoy there!
It's Hook! He's coming down the path! We're trapped!
Follow me.
It is the captain!
Captain, is all well?
All is very well. Where's Tiger Lily?
It's all right, Captain. We let her go.
Let her go?
What's your own orders, Captain?
You called us to let her go. Stone and gog? What cosmic is this? Peter Pan!
Agua! Agua!
shelter to sleep after all this excitement?
We'll go up now. We'll keep guard and watch the pirates.
Good night!
Now, children, make your father comfortable.
Here's your chair, father.
Here are your slippers, father.
Here's your paper, father.
Now, go wash up. It's your bedtime. They are sweet, aren't they, Peter? Peter? Peter, what is it?
I was just thinking. It's only pretend, isn't it, that I'm their father?
Yes, but they are ours, Peter. Yours and mine.
But not really.
Well, no.
Not if you don't wish it.
I don't.
We're all ready for bed now, Mother.
I even brushed my teeth.
Peter, shall we sing the children a lullaby?
It's over. quiet. Who won? If the brave girls have won, they'll beat on the drum. Listen. The drum of brave girl victory. You're perfectly safe now, Wendy. Tiger Lily will escort you through the woods. Bye, boys. Lead the way, team. I won't forget it. Peter, if you come for me once a year, I'll do your spring cleaning. Will you come?
If you like.
You won't forget. Peter, oh, Peter, how I wish I could pick you up and squeeze you.
Wendy, wait. Here.
For you. Take them over to the ship. The boys, we will make walk the plank. And Wendy will be our mother.
What about Peter?
This is for Peter.
Poison?
Aye, he's doomed.
Thank you. How still the night is. Nothing sounds alive. Now is the hours when children in their homes are abed, their lips bright brown with the goodnight chocolate, and their tongues drowsily searching for belated crumbs housed insecurely on their shining cheeks. Compare with them, the captive children on this boat. Split with infinitives, but tis the hour of triumph. At last I've reached me peak. I'm the greatest villain of all time. Becoming a pirate, me hearty.
What would you call me if I joined?
Blackbeard Joe.
Thanks for being loyal to the flag.
What? You would have to swear down with the flag.
And I refuse.
And I refuse.
That seals your doom. Bring aboard their mother. Now, me proud beauty, you are about to watch your children walk the plank.
Are they to die?
They are! Silence. Silence all. For a mother's last words to her sons.
The
The clock! Protect me! Protect me! Protect me!
There's Jonah aboard.
It's Peter Pan, the Avenger.
Peter!
So, Pan, this is all your doing.
I hope it is all my doing.
We'll
Andy! Michael John!
Mother!
Oh, a little less noise, please. A little less noise.
Father! Oh,
Father!
John, Michael, Wendy!
Who are they?
There are a few more of us. Won't you adopt them?
All of them?
Please, Father?
George, don't you think we could manage?
Well, it's another six or seven. Make yourselves.
You won't forget me. Peter, please, please don't forget.